again I am there with you with some problems which are depend on the volume of cone. Okay, so today's first problem is a cone height 24 cm has a curved surface area 550 cm square. Find its volume. Okay, we have to find out volume. What is given here? Curved surface area is given, that is 550 cm square. Okay, and height is given 24 cm. Understood? And asking, they are asking find its volume. Okay, as we know that we are using for volume 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, what is our formula to find out volume of cone? 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, so now here we don't have radius, we don't have radius, we have height. Height is given 24 cm, radius is not given. Value of pi 22 by 7 is given, but with the help of this given things we cannot find out directly volume. Okay, so first we need to find out radius. Okay, so to find out radius, what we are going to do, we have to use this height. Okay, to find out this radius, we are going to use this height. We know that L is equals to what? L equals to under root h square plus r square plus h square. Okay, so here r we don't have. Okay, L also we don't have. Understood? So what we will do here, L is equals to r square. What is r square? R is not given, so we will put r as it is, r square plus h. Height is given 24, so 24 square. Okay, so L is equals to under root r square plus 24 square is 576. Okay, so this is, we got here slanting height. L is known as slanting height. Okay, so now one more thing they have given us, curved surface area. Curved surface area is 550. Curved surface area is given 550. Okay, to find out curved surface area of cone, we use formula pi r. Okay, curved surface area, CS, curved surface area of cone is equals to pi r l. Okay, so from that r is unknown. So again, the value of L which we have here, that we will put here. Okay, and curved surface area, that is 550, so that we can put directly here. Okay, so now I am taking that value of this is 550 is equals to 22 by 7 multiply by radius we don't have, so r, and this is L is slanting height, and this is r square plus 576. Okay, so now again we have here one square root. Okay, so what we can do here, after this 7 I will take here. Okay, so what I will get here, 550 multiply by 7 divided by 22 is equal to r into r square plus 576. Okay, so now here we can, this is here, we can divide by 22. 11 2s are 22, 11 5s are 55, here 50 remains 7, so 2 1s are 2, 2 25s are 50. So here what is remaining, 25 multiplied by 7 is equal to r into under root r square plus 576. Okay, so now I am taking this here whole strip once again, that is r under root r square plus 576 is equal to 25 multiplied by 7. Okay, the same step I have taken here. Now what we can do, I want to cancel this square root. So I need to take square of both the sides. Okay, so now I am taking square of both the sides, that is r under root r square plus 576 whole square is equal to 25 multiplied by 7 brackets. Okay, or we can write directly also 25 square and 7 square. That way also we can write. Now we have seen, when I will take square of this, that time what I will get? I need to take square of this r square. Okay, r square under root, what will we get? The square root will be, what is going to remain? R square plus 576 is equal to 25 square multiplied by 7 square. Or this we can take this side also in LHS. Okay, so now here see what I will get here, r square into r square, it will be R square into R square will be R raised to 4 plus 576 R square. Okay, minus 25 square into 7 square. Okay, 25 square into 7 square is equal to 0. These LHS, RHS we have taken in LHS. Understood? Now what we can do here, see. What we can do here? Here we can factorize this. This 576 we can factorize. Okay. So how we can factorize? That is R raised to 4 plus this we can factorize 625 R square. 625 R square minus 49 R square. Okay. The subtraction of this C, 15 minus 9 will be 6, means the 625 minus 49 will be 576. Okay, means the same we have taken in terms of this subtraction, 625 R square minus 49 R square minus 25 square into 7 square. 25 square into 7 square, or we can take here 625 into 49, that will also we can take. Okay, so now see here, we have now here one term and this is one. Okay, so now I am taking this C, R raised to 4 plus 625 R square minus 49 R square minus 625, okay, minus 625 into 49. So see, from these two terms and from this term, this is, there are also two terms and here also two terms, okay. So from this we can take R square common. Okay, because here R raised to 4 and here R square. So R square we can take common. So now I am taking here R square. What is going to remain here? R square plus 625. R square plus 625. Okay. Now what we can take here common? 49 minus 49. So what is going to remain here? R square plus 625. Okay. Minus 49 we have taken here common. So what is going to remain here? R square plus 625. Okay. So now after this, we have two same brackets. So instead of that, I am taking now R square plus 625 in another bracket, R square minus 49. R square minus 49. Okay. So now we can solve further. That is, see here we have two terms. So we cannot use this R square plus 625. Okay. Because this will be equals to 0, this whole is equals to 0, okay. But this value will get negative, R square is equal to minus 625, so that we cannot use, so that we are not going to think about that. Now second, what is given? R square minus 49 is equals to 0, so R square equals to what? Plus 49, so R is equals to 7 centimeter, because the square root of 49 is 7 centimeter, 7, okay, so R is equal to 7 centimeter, okay. So now we have radius, okay, we have radius, we have height, okay. Now here we have to find out volume of this cone, okay. So now volume is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h. Volume is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h, okay. So now 1 by 3 into 22 by 7 multiplied by radius is 7 multiplied by 7 into height is 24. So 24 I am taking here. Okay. So from this 7 will be cancelled. 3 ones are 3. 3 8s are 24. Now what is remaining here? 22 multiplied by 7 8s are 56 centimeter cube. Understood? And this product is 1232 centimeter. Okay, so this is our required answer. Okay, so see carefully, once again I am showing you here. The question was, a cone height 24 cm has a curved surface area 550 cm square. Okay, find its volume. Here we have to find out volume, but as we know, the formula of volume is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, we have radius, but we don't have radius, we have height. But without radius, we cannot find out volume. So first, we need to find out radius. Okay. So to find out radius, we have to use here slanting height. L is equals to under root r square plus h square. Okay. Okay, so this way we can find out slanting angle. So L is equals to radius r square, because that is unknown, so it will remain as it is. H is given 24, so 24 square. Then L is equals to r square plus 576. Understood? So now this is the slanting angle. One more thing they have given us, curved surface area. Okay, so curved surface area is 550 centimeter square. So that we have taken, curved surface area is equal to pi r. That formula we use to find out curved surface area. So 550 curved surface area is equal to pi 22 by 7, radius r will be as it is L, which we have got here, that we have to put in. Understood? So finally we got 550, this 7 we have to multiply divided by 22, is equal to r under root r square plus 576. So same step I have taken here. Okay. So in this 22, 25 are 550 multiplied by 7. So 25 to 7 is here. Now I want to cancel this square root. So I need to take square of both LHS and RHS. So what I have done? We have to take squares of LHS and RHS. So here r square root will cancel here, because square root into square root, it will be cancelled. So r square plus 576 will remain as it is equal to 25 square into 7 square. Okay. Now this product r raised to 4, r square into 576 r square. This will come in LHS, minus 25 square into 7 square. This 576 we have to express in terms of this 2, 525 r square minus 49 r square. Why this we have done here? To take common parts. Understood? Okay, so for that 625 r square minus 49 r square, the product of these two is equals to 576. Okay, so from these two terms we have taken r raised to 4 plus 625 r square, we have taken r square common, so it is remaining in bracket r raised to 2 plus 625, and from these two terms we have taken minus 49, so in bracket remain r square plus 625. Okay, so finally we got two brackets, r square plus 625, r square minus 49. Okay, this we cannot use, r square plus 625 we cannot use, because you will get negative value, and that radius can't be negative. Understood? So that we are not going to think about that. R square minus 49 is equal to 0. So r square, r is equal to 7 centimeter. Okay, now we have radius, we have height also. So with the help of these two things we can find out volume. So volume formula is 1 by 3 pi r square h. So 1 by 3 into 22 by 7, the product of this is 22 multiplied by 56. 1232 centimeter cube is the required answer. That is the volume of this cone. Our second problem is, two cones have their heights in the ratio 1:3 and the radii of their bases in the ratio 3:1. Find the ratio of their volumes. Okay, we have to find out their volumes, and ratios are given. Okay, what is given first? Two cones have their heights in the ratio 1:3. Okay, so first we need to consider here, let the heights of cone be h and 3h. Okay, h is the height of first cone and 3h is the height of second cone. Okay, like that we will consider radii of cone be 3r and r. 3r and r. Okay, so height and radii. So now we are going to find out volume first. V1 is equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, first volume. So in first volume we will use this height and this is radius. Okay, so 1 by 3 into pi, because ratio we are going to find out, so pi will be automatically cancelled. So r is 3r, 3r bracket square into h will be as it is h. Okay, so now this will be 1 by 3 into pi into this 3 will be into 9r square h. Okay, so 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. So what is going to remain here? 3 pi r square h. Okay, now we will find out second volume of second cone. So that is V2 is equal to again the same formula, 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, so here 1 by 3 into pi r square. Okay, what is the radius of second? That is, we will take only r square, so that r square will remain as it is. Height is 3h, so multiply by 3h. So here we can cancel this thing. So what is going to remain here? Pi r square h. Okay, so this is the volume of second cone. This is the volume of first cone. Okay, so here now we have to find out ratio. So v1 upon v2 is equal to 3 pi r square h divided by pi r square h. 3 pi r square h divided by pi r square h. So this pi r square h will be cancelled. So that is 3 upon 1. So v2 is equal to 3:1. So that will be the required ratio. Okay. Once again, see very simple example. The ratio they are asking. Two cones have their heights in the ratio 1:3. Okay, heights are given 1:3. So we have taken h and 3h. 1h and 3h. That is h and 3h. And the radii of their bases in the ratio 3:1. So 3r and r. Okay, so that we have taken 3r and r. So now volume first 1/3 pi r square h. So 1/3 pi r square is 3r square into h. 1/3 pi 3 square is 9 r square h. So 3 3s are 9. So here it is remaining 3 pi r square h. Here volume 2 1/3 pi r square h. So that time you use this height and this is radius. So 1/3 pi r square will remain as it is, and height we have taken 3h. So pi r square h, when 3 will be cancelled, pi r square h. And here we have to find out ratio. So we have taken v1 by v2. So 3 pi r square h upon pi r square h. Pi r square h will be cancelled, 3 upon 1. So that is 3:1. This is the required ratio. Thank you.